Word on the Run with Pastor Marius Swart.
Beloved, welcome to Word on the Run. And we are busy with 50 days to Pentecost, and we are in day 33 of our 50 days to Pentecost. We are busy speaking in our fifth week about the proof of the Holy Spirit. Now, 2 Corinthians 1 verse 22 says, "He who establishes us with you in Christ and has anointed us is God, who also has sealed us and given us the Spirit in our hearts as a guarantee." Now, you and I must know that we are sealed by the Holy Spirit of promise, according to Ephesians 1 verse 13. The word seal is the word skrachizo, which means to mark with a seal, or as a means of identification, or a mark that denotes ownership, and also is a mark of the protection of the owner. Now, the word seal is used in different occasions. Now, a seal normally authenticates. So it actually denotes that we are the genuine product. So it actually authenticates that is the true product. Now, notary public seals, or seal of an official of a document, was normally given. We know that years back in olden years, we would find that people would use their ring as a seal and approval that was authenticated by the king, or was authenticated by the person who sent that letter or sent that a product. And therefore, a seal was given as authentication to whom it belongs, and that it is the genuine product. Now, the Amplified Bible says, God has also appropriated and acknowledged us as His by putting His seal upon us. So it is confirming that we are coming from Him, and the seal is also, the Holy Spirit as a seal, is a confirmation that it comes from Him. So it is authenticating that we are coming from Him and we are His, and that the Holy Spirit also comes from Him. Then secondly, the Holy Spirit is a mark, or the seal is a mark of ownership. So the Holy Spirit confirms that we are belonging to God. In the Good News Bible, the Bible says, "Who has placed His mark of ownership upon us, confirming we belong to Him, we are His." So it's not only authenticating us, it's also the mark of ownership. Thirdly, it is a mark of security. The BBE translation says this. Now, the Bible says, "He who has placed His mark of ownership upon us, confirming that we belong to Him." Now, the BBE translation says this, "And it is He who has put His stamp on us." The Message Bible says, "By His Spirit He has stamped us with His eternal pledge." Now, we know that when a bottle is sealed, it is sealed with that stamp, and it's sealed with that approval. We know that medicine bottles also were sealed, and that seal cannot be broken. And when the seal is broken, then that security is also broken. So we must know that the Holy Spirit is that seal of security, that we belong to Him, we are His, and also that we are secured by Him. So God has fully examined us. God has fully made sure that we are the original, and we belong to Him. Now, it's not of our own doing. It is by Jesus Christ that God is actually putting His stamp of approval. And God is actually approving us. He's endorsing us. He's recognizing us. He's affirming us. He has sanctified us. And now He has notarized us by the Holy Spirit that was given by God. So the Bible also says it is our conviction that when a person obeys the gospel, he is given the Holy Spirit, and this is the way that God seals the person, that you and I get the Holy Spirit as a seal, as a stamp of approval. Ephesians 4 verse 3 says, and do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. We find in Ephesians 1:13, the Bible says, in him you who also trusted, after you heard the word of the truth, the gospel of the salvation, in whom you also have believed, you were sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. Then we find even in Revelation 7 verse 3, the Bible says, saying, harm neither the earth nor the sea nor the trees until we have sealed the bond servants of our God upon their foreheads. You and I must know that the Holy Spirit is a seal not only of God's approval, not only of his authentication, but it's a seal that we can know, it's his stamp of approval that we are getting to know that one day we are going to get more from him than what we have received up to now. But we have been sealed by the Holy Spirit, belonging to him, and he's authenticating us in him. Let us pray. Father God, thank you that we can today just receive the baptism in the Holy Spirit and the speaking in other tongues, and that proof of the Holy Spirit in us serves as a seal, it serves as a stamp, it serves as the guarantee, it serves as a proof to others that we really belong to God, and God has given us the Spirit to prove this. Let your name be glorified in us and through us. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.